Good morning. Happy Thursday, everyone. All right, it's Thursday. Getting close to the weekend. Some time for me and for family and for friends. I welcome you to my Bible study. This Bible study is sponsored by the Church of God of Prophecy in Simi Valley. My pastor has authorized me to do this Bible study and to post it on the church's YouTube site. And so I've committed to doing a daily Bible study. This is the study that I do for myself each morning, and I'm sharing it online so that maybe others will be encouraged to study the Word of God. And so we'll continue this week's study about passages that are difficult to understand. And so we're in the book of Revelations, and we're studying mysteries in the Revelation. And so we're just wrapping up section one, and we're at section 1C. Before we get started, let's say good morning to our Father. Dear Father in heaven, thank you for waking us up this morning. Thank you for loving us so much that you provide all we need. Thank you for being our rock. Thank you for allowing us to depend on you for our existence and for all our needs. Thank you for being the warrior that stands for truth and fights our battles. Thank you for giving us the confidence that we can stand on your word and nothing can come against us. Thank you, Father, for your love, for your care, for your understanding, your mercy. Thank you for your patience, your grace, your unmerited favor, Father. Thank you for your long suffering in this world. Thank you for your sacrifice, the sacrifice of your Son, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, that you make us a priority in all that you do. You're great, God. You're great, and you're beyond my comprehension. But my faith allows me to know without a doubt that there's nothing I should fear, because you are with me. Father, help us to understand you and to know your word and be obedient and in agreement with you. I pray that this study helps someone, encourages someone to seek you. That's my desire. Thank you, Father, in your Son Jesus Christ's precious name. Amen. Sorry for that long prayer. Sometimes when I talk to God, it goes on and on. There's just no end to the praise that he deserves. Okay, let's get into the study. The prediction of Isaiah, Isaiah 11, verses 1 and 2. And it reads, "And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord." And the commentary reads, John's multiple references to the Holy Spirit as seven spirits brings to mind the prophecy of Isaiah, in which he predicted the sevenfold spirit would rest upon the Messiah. The spirit that is on the Messiah is, number one, the spirit of the Lord. Verse 2 in the New King James Version. Because the spirit of the Lord is upon him, the Messiah will possess special qualities that make him an ideal ruler. The spirit is, number 2, the spirit of wisdom. Wisdom is an indispensable qualification for a ruler. The spirit of, number 3, understanding goes hand in hand with wisdom. Wisdom is the ability to know what is good, and understanding is the ability to distinguish the best course of action when presented with opposing choices. The Messiah would also have, number 4, the spirit of counsel, and number 5, might. The word counsel is the same as the name counselor in Isaiah 9:6, and the word might means strength or power. Furthermore, the Spirit would give him, 6, the knowledge necessary to rule over the kingdom of God. The Spirit knows all things and would dispense that knowledge to God's chosen ruler. Finally, the Messiah will display 7, the fear of the Lord, which signifies a deep reverence for the Lord and for his commandments. The Messiah possesses special qualities that make him a great leader. And these qualities are wisdom, understanding, counsel, might, knowledge, and fear of the Lord. And so these things uniquely in total make the Messiah a extremely qualified leader. No one is better at leading than the Messiah, because he has been anointed by the Father for this leadership. Okay, section 2. And this is titled Numbers in the Revelation. Okay, numbers function as important symbols in the Bible. For example, the number 7 and its multiples, 70, 77, 700, etc., represent completion and wholeness. See Genesis 4:24, Genesis 41:2, Exodus 24, verse 1, 2 Samuel, verse 24, or chapter 24, verse 15, Jeremiah, chapter 25, verse 11, Matthew 18, verse 22, Luke 10, 1. The number 4 symbolizes creation and created things. See Genesis 2, verse 10. Ezekiel 1, verse 5, Zechariah 1, verses 18 through 20, Zechariah 6, verse 1, and Mark 13, 27. The number 40 stands for one generation. See Genesis 7, verse 17, 25, verse 20, Exodus 16:35, Judges 3:11, and 1 Samuel 4:18. The number hand has five fingers on each hand. So five represent humanity. The heavens and the earth were created in 6 days. So six symbolizes labor and its results. Eight, being the start of a new week, represents new beginnings. Therefore, baby boys are circumcised on the eighth day, Luke 1:59. The seven-day Feast of Tabernacles, called the eighth day or the great day in John 7:37, is the first day of the next calendar of feasts. And that's from Levi chapter 23:36. Numbers in the Revelation. Okay. This is section 2, and we're moving on to 2A. It's titled The Number 7 in the Book of Revelations. And this references our Revelation chapter 1, verse 10 to 13, chapter 1, verse 16, verse 20, and chapter 5, verse 1, chapter 8, verse 2, chapter 15, verse 1, and chapter 16, verse 1. Let's start with Revelations 1 and 20. The mystery of the seven stars, which thou sawest in my right hand, and the seven candlesticks. The seven stars are the angels of the seven churches, and the seven candlesticks which thou sawest are the seven churches. Revelation 5:1. And I saw in the right hand of him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside, sealed with seven seals. Revelation 16:1. And I heard a great voice out of the temple saying to the seven angels, go your ways and pour out the vials of the wrath of God upon the earth. Okay, here's the commentary. The most prominent number in the book of Revelation is the number 7. There are 7 prophetic messages to the 7 churches of Asia. The 7 churches are symbolized by 7 golden lampstands, signifying the churches are lights to the dark world. And that's Matthew 5:14, Ephesians 5:8, Philippians 2:15. The 7 churches are guided by 7 stars, which are the angels or messengers of the 7 churches. Revelation 1:20. Jesus holds these stars in his hand, which mean he directs the work of the angels as they watch over the churches. After all, Jesus is the head of the church, and every element of the church is under his control and direction. And that's from Colossians chapter 1:18. The number 7 is also used in Revelation to represent God's complete judgment of the earth. These judgments come in the form of 7 seals. Revelation 5:1. 7 trumpets, Revelation 8:2, and 7 plagues, Revelation 15:1. This series of sevens is cynical. That is, they represent God's judgment repeated three times. Once for the Father, and once for the Son, and once for the Holy Spirit. The judgments are unleashed by seven angels. Revelations 8 and 2, Revelations 15, 1, Revelations 16, 1. After the opening of the scroll that is sealed with seven seals. Well, it looks like this is a good place to stop. We were talking about numbers in Revelation. And numbers are symbols in the Bible. You know, the multiples of seven representing completion. The number 40 representing a generation. The number 5 representing humanity. The 7 lampstands for the 7 churches, the 7 stars for the angels of the churches, a lot of references and definition, I guess, of the meaning of numbers. The 7-day Feast of Tabernacles is Israel's annual feast. And the day following the Feast of Tabernacles, called the 8th day or the Great Day, is the first day of the next calendar feast. Numbers are symbols. Very simply put, they're symbols. They represent a accumulation of things, and they represent certain functions, like the multiples of 7 represent completion or wholeness. So, yeah, we'll end that here, and tomorrow's study will be the 24 elders and the 4 beasts. And so we will continue our study with that. And also we'll talk about the 144,000. And how about 7 heads and 10 horns? There's a lot of symbolism in the Bible for us. So we'll continue our study tomorrow. But today, we're going to live for the Lord. Today, we're going to commune with the Lord. Today, we're going to praise God and go about our day as victors, knowing that no matter what we face, we have the victory in Jesus. So have a blessed day, everyone. Thank God for all that you have and all that you are, because it is all because of Him. God bless you all.